wife.
Sure, she used to have nipples that would stand up and whistle Dixie, but then again, at one point, dinosaurs used to roam the earth.
Yeah.
I have three pairs of shoes. I got my white Nikes.
I love the white Nikes.
Okay, I've had those for what, 6, 7 years, right? Things are almost worn out. I got my Bruno Magnus. I can't wear those anymore because of the fucking OJ thing, right? And so I go out and I buy these boots. Look at these.
Nice. Huh? Nice fucking boots.
You know what those are?
What?
Stingray.
The fish?
Yeah, of course the fish.
So you got fish boots.
I'm wearing stingray boots, man. These are one of a kind.
Fish boots? How much they cost?
$1,500.
$1,500? You paid $1,500 for those fucking shoes? No wonder your wife is pissed.
You sound like my fucking wife.
But anybody would be pissed on that end. Come on.
Okay, you know what? Just shut up about the fucking
boots. Well, I'll forget about it.
Sorry I fucking brought it up. You know what I mean. This fucking guy. God, get off the fucking car. Get off the car. Get off the fucking car. Get off the fucking car.
Okay. Just give me a dollar, okay?
What?
You got a Benz. I got a busket. Give me a dollar.
A busket? Give me the busket.
No.
Give me the busket.
Oh.
Tell you what. I'll give you $500 for that busket. Right?
Okay.
Put the bottle in the busket. Put the rag in the busket. Hand it to me.
Come on, leave him alone.
Go to a hotel, get a room, shower, shave, get a suit, get a fucking job, get off the sauce. If I see you in the streets again with a busket, I'm gonna fucking shoot you. All right?
You're right.
Okay. All right, screw him.
You're all right, man.
All right.
You're all right, man.
All right. See, all these guys need a little guidance sometimes, right?
Fuck! Can I have a cigarette, maybe?
Give me the gun.
Give me the fucking gun.
Come on, leave him alone. Get back in the car.
Yeah, man, you fucking prick.
I've got enough
problems. Yeah. God damn, Jesus Christ. Fucking piss. Shit. You fucking believe I gave that guy $500? Jesus.
Between him and the boots, you're down $2,000.
Don't ever mention the fucking boots to me again. You got that?
Sorry, Lano.
Not fucking funny.
I know, I'm kidding.
I don't want to hear about any fucking kind of footwear from you ever again.
I won't.
Don't even talk about fucking socks to me.
All right, I won't.
Don't touch any buttons, for Christ's sake. Yeah.
You're looking good.
I'm talking to you!
I'm gone out.
Well, then how about you get your new daddy another beer? Oh, now you ought to learn to control that temper of yours. You're getting more like your fucking mother every day. Hmm? Well, what's good enough for her ain't good enough for you.
Jennifer.
Oh, Paul, what are you doing here?
What happened to you? Wait here, okay?
Who the hell are you?
Why don't you just think of me as a friend of the family?
Get the fuck out of my house, asshole.
Well, if you give me a couple minutes of your time, I've got a few things I'd like to talk to you about. You know, what you did wasn't really your fault. It's what they call a genetic defect. Mom called it the gene. My grandfather had the gene. He came over on the boat from Ireland in 1912. And I guess he passed it on to my old man. My old man was a great guy. Real pussycat, you know, hard worker. Big sports fan. Sometimes on his way home from the docks, he liked to stop in with the guys and have a couple of beers, you know. I remember coming home from school one day and the whole house was dark. Couldn't figure it out. Heard my mom crying off in the dark someplace. And I was old enough at that point I could reach the light switch. I turned the lights on, and I saw what he did to her. So I went to my room and I got the baseball bat, Mickey Mantle model my old man gave me for Christmas. And I found the old man passed out in the bathtub. And I tattooed him. Needless to say, when I came home every day from school after that, the house is lit up like Ebbets Field. The old man never drank again. So, all I'm saying to you is if you want to drink, you go ahead and drink. But if I ever find out that you laid your hands on that little girl again, me and Mr. Mantle are going to pay you a visit, my friend.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Good. Oh. On your way out, send that little whore back in here. I haven't finished with her yet.
About the toaster.
Anytime.
Hey, there were a couple of your friends who were down at the bar this afternoon. You know their names?
Yeah, Avery, Max, Brett.